So when we are spending so much of time, why is it that you people are not responding? 48 years I have been coming here. How many times you have heard the Gita verses? From nobody's mouth will come these verses. I don't know what is the wrong with you. I think you should spend more time, more attention and more effort.
Vidwan satasma upasattimi yushe mumukshave sadhu yathoktakarine prashanta cittaya samanvitaya tattvopadesham kripayaiva kuryat.
You know the impression? People, what people said, Swamiji, it is something very great and huge. We should have done it right from the first year. Nobody asked for it. And it is a village folk, you should understand. There are other people, also educated people, but you will find a large number of rural population. All of them are reciting it with so much of involvement. So it has instituted a new culture in the whole area.
Vidwan satasma.
Vidwan satasma.
Upasattimi yushe.
Upasattimi yushe.
Mumukshave.
Mumukshave.
Sadhu.
Sadhu.
Yathoktakarine.
Yathoktakarine.
Mumukshave sadhu yathoktakarine.
Mumukshave sadhu yathoktakarine.
Prashanta cittaya.
Prashanta cittaya.
Shamanvitaya.
Shamanvitaya.
Prashanta cittaya shamanvitaya.
Prashanta cittaya shamanvitaya.
Tattvopadesham.
Tattvopadesham.
Kripayaiva kuryat.
Kripayaiva kuryat.
Tattvopadesham kripayaiva kuryat.
Tattvopadesham kripayaiva kuryat.
Vidwan.
Vidwan.
Saha.
Saha.
Tasmai.
Tasmai.
Upasattim.
Upasattim.
Iyushe.
Iyushe.
Mumukshave.
Mumukshave.
Sadhu.
Sadhu.
Yathoktakarine.
Yathoktakarine.
Prashanta cittaya.
Prashanta cittaya.
Shamanvitaya.
Shamanvitaya.
Tattvopadesham.
Tattvopadesham.
Kripaya.
Kripaya.
Eva.
Eva.
Kripayaiva.
Kripayaiva.
Kuryat.
Kuryat.
In brief, the verse says that to the seeker who has approached the Guru in such a loyal and submissive, fond manner, the teacher should explain the secret, the truth, without any reservation, with a lot of sympathy, compassion.
Vidwan satasma upasattimiyushe.
Vidwan, the knowledgeable man, the man of knowledge, self-knowledge, saha vidwan, that teacher, tasmai, to the disciple who has approached in this manner, upasattimiyushe, upasattim iyushe. From the words of the disciple, the manner in which he has approached, from his looks, from his eyes, from all these expressions he can understand, he has come with an exclusive devotion and reliance to the Guru. When he finds that he has come with a lot of fondness, reliance, loyalty and integrity, mumukshave, he is also seeking liberation from the shackles of the mind and intelligence. Whenever we say moksha, even now many people think that it is avoiding a further birth from another mother's womb. It is not that. As you have bandhana, bondage now, here itself you should also have the realization or experience of moksha. Bandha or bondage is a state of clouding. The mind is not clear. It feels constricted in various ways. The intelligence has no real insight and clarity. The intelligence has no clarity, enlightenment. So in the shackles produced by the mind and intelligence, we feel a lot stifled, tormented. It is this situation that has to be cleared, and you must have a feeling of freedom and release. So the release or moksha that you are expecting is in the hands of your own mind and your own intelligence. Where you feel bondage, there itself you should realize the freedom. If bondage is at the tip of the nose, okay, liberation also will be at the tip of the nose. If you think that it is in the mind level itself is freedom. It is not after the death that you are going to become a mukta, right here. So, mumukshave sadhu yathokta karine, this disciple who has come and surrendered in this manner, sought in this manner, expressed his resolve in this manner, he clearly understands whatever instruction is given to him, he will obey it, he will practice it with fidelity. Yathokta karine, whatever is mentioned in the Shastras, he will pay obeisance to the Shastras, heed the Shastras, so there is no doubt. So there will be no disloyalty or disintegrity or lack of fervor on his part in the matter of observing and heeding whatever instructions are given. Yathokta karine, prashanta chittaya samanvidaya. These are words you can apply to yourself. Am I a seeker? Have I gone to my guru in this manner? Was there any deficiency, any inadequacy? Then look into it and improve your lot. Then, prashanta chittaya, you must have a mind with is shanta, quiet, calm. Samanvidaya, there are six virtues or disciplines. Shamadamadi shatka sampatihi, in sadhana chadushtayam, in his mention. Sadhana chadushtaya means fourfold prerequisites for seeking and attaining moksha or self-knowledge. One is nityanitya vastu vivegaha. The second is ikhamutra phala bhoga viragaha. The third is shamadamadi shatka sampatihi. And the fourth is mumukshutva. Now shamadama, tidiksha, shraddha, samadhana, etc. These are the six virtues. He has all that. His mind is not crowded with desires. He is not after anything in this world. Everything is in his own mind. He is not interested in anything. You know, whatever you have from the world, ultimately it gives you joy. This joy is produced by the mind. It is emotional in character. So keeping the mind within your heart, why should you look for joy from external objects? It is not necessary at all. So he is very clear that what I want is incessant and perpetual unbroken joy for which the key lies with my own mind. An object, only when we interact with the object, we get interactional consequence called joy. And this joy is inner. Maybe you look at your child and you feel joyous. The child is only an object. The child is only an object. Joy is emotional and inner. Looking at the child, your mind produces the joy. Mind produces the joy. So if you want to have the joy, you can look into the mind and you get the joy. What is philosophy? Philosophy is the science of generating joy solely by your mind. And what is worldly life? Looking for joy from interactions with the objects. Not knowing that, even when you interact with the object, the interaction is mental and the resulting experiences also are mental. So mind is the source and terminus of everything. That point is missed and we become outward, extrovert. Am I clear? Prashanta chittaya samanvidaya tattvopadesham kripayaiva kuryat. To such a seeker, he must go on explaining the truth of the self. So what the guru does is only an exposure, an explanation, a disclosure. He makes everything clear for the disciple. Now, what is the first assurance he gives? You know, this is a verse that in my life I would have uttered this several times because I like these things. Ma bhaishta vidvam stabhanastyapaya samsara sindhostarane stupaya yenaiva yata yatayosya param tameva margam tava nirdishami. This is the beauty and greatness of our tradition. Our Guru Parampara is practically endless and beginningless. We don't know who was the first Guru, where from the first Guru came. If you look into Mundaka Upanishad, you will find Brahma Devanam Prathamas Sambhuva. Initially there was Brahma. Brahma had his children and he called his children and said, while you are living in this world, you will require this knowledge in order to support and sustain you. As a part of this parental obligation, parental duty, indebtedness, he also called them and taught them Brahma Vidya. This is how every one of you parents should do. You must be able to teach Brahma Vidya to your children. For that you must first of all possess it. You feel by giving birth to them, bodily birth, by educating them, spending money, also purchasing a house for them, helping them in their employment, giving them a monetary treasure when you go, your duty is over. Certainly not. So our Brahma Vidya comes from Brahma himself, the creator. So nobody says that this is something that I have found out. See the manner in which Shankara has described it. Ma bhaiṣṭa vidvam stavanāstyapāyah samsāra sindhostarane stupāyah ma bhaiṣṭa vidvam stava nāstyapāyah mā bhaiṣṭa vidvam stava nāstyapāyah
mā bhaiṣṭa vidvam stava nāstyapāyah.
There is a Silva Roy in Delhi. She is an Estonian lady who migrated from Russia to America. Many, many years back she came to me. She must have come to Jamshedpur also, yes, isn't it?
Yes.
A short, fair lady. You know, how studiously she learned Sanskrit and she started reciting verses. And you Jamshedpurians cannot do. I sometimes wonder what is wrong with all of you. How she was reciting the Sanskrit verses? In 1973, when I was standing for a short while, in John F. Kennedy Airport in the United States. You know, a young girl came to me. I was a little surprised. And she started reciting the first three verses of Srimad Bhagavatam in beautiful, chaste Sanskrit. What she wanted to do is, she had Srimad Bhagavatam and said, I would like you to buy this copy. That was her purpose. Belonging to the Krishna consciousness people. How they study? But why is it that you are not able to study? Will you chant at least three verses before me, every one of you? Every year I am coming. So I think some loyalty, integrity, self-motivation is lacking in all of you, I believe. Yenaiva yata
yenaiva yata
yatayosya param
yatayosya param
yenaiva yata yatayosya param
yenaiva yata yatayosya param
tameva margam
tameva margam
tavanirdishami
tavanirdishami
tameva margam tavanirdishami
tameva margam tava
मा
मा
भैष्टा
भैष्टा
विद्वन
विद्वन
तवा
तवा
विद्वंस्तवा
विद्वंस्तवा
न
न
अस्ति
अस्ति
अपायः
अपायः
नास्ति अपायः
नास्ति अपायः
संसारसिन्धोः
संसारसिन्धोः
तरणे
तरणे
अस्ति
अस्ति
उपायः
उपायः
संसार सिंधोस्तरणे स्त्युपायः
संसार सिंधोस्तरणे स्त्युपायः
येन
येन
एव
एव
येनैव
येनैव
याता
याता
यतयः
यतयः
अस्य
अस्य
यतयोस्य
यतयोस्य
पारं
पारं
तं
तम
एवा
एवा
तमेवा
तमेवा
मार्गम
मार्गम
तवा
तया
निर्दिशामि
निर्दिशामि
मा भैष्ठा माय डियर सन माय डियर डॉटर डू नॉट फियर एट ऑल यू हैव कम टू मी योर लाइफ इज सेफ डू नॉट फियर अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट एनी मोर हैव फुल एश्योरेंस रिलीफ प्रॉमिस नेवर वरी अबाउट इट हे विद्वन बिकॉज यू हैव एक्सप्रेस्ड दिस काइंड ऑफ यर्निंग बिफोर मी आई कॉल यू ए नॉलेजेबल पर्सन You are the person who has the right knowledge in life. All the others are ignorant and deluded. They are interested. They are interested like dogs. Eating, eating, eating. With the mouth, with the eyes. They are all interested only in the ephemeral world and the ephemeral objects. You have at least sensed that the world is ephemeral, evanescent. It is fleeting. And I must have something different and greater. This discrimination is what makes a man knowledgeable and not anything else. It is not the knowledge of physics, chemistry, engineering, anthropology, biology, and all that. The real knowledge which makes you happy is the spiritual discrimination. In as much as you have it, I call you, you are a knowledgeable person. Tava nasti apayaha. You will never have any apaya, danger or calamity in this world. I am very sure about it. And be assured. Samsara sindho tarane. In the matter of crossing the ocean of worldliness, asti upayaha, there is a very clever and hidden method. What is the hidden method? The entire world, you feel that it is objective, objective, objective. But is it objective or is it a reflection or is it an imagination floating in your mind? Boliye? So far as I am concerned, are you there or are you there as bubbles in my mind? Chup rehte hain, dekhi. Suppose I have no eyes, I become blind. Will any one of you be felt by me so far as your color and shape, dress, etc. are concerned? So the entire world is produced by our senses. And the senses are produced by the inward presence. Our body is shaped by the power inside. The senses are part of the body. And the senses are employed by the mind. And only when the mind employs the senses, the mind alone takes an imprint of the objects in itself. So all the things that I see, the huge trees, the pathway, the vehicles, the walls, the roof, so many people seated in front, all of them, are they really physical and external? Or are they really on examination, inner, and pictured in the mind by the mind. Boliye na theek. Can you say that you are all my mind pictures, mind imprints. The imprint is caused by the mind and the imprint is in itself in the mind. So they are mental imprints. If they are mind's imprints, the mind is capable of completely wiping them off. That is what happens in the sleep state. You are waking up, and when you wake up, the extensive world is seen. The extensive world is seen when you wake up. And when you go to sleep, exactly the whole process is wiped off. So don't you agree that the consciousness in our body, which animates and activates the body, has got sufficient independent sovereign power to generate the world as well as to obliterate it? Agree or not? Boliye na zor se. This is the discrimination. So we don't have to cross the world. We will wipe it off in our own mind. No swimming, nothing is required. Our mind is projecting the world. Our mind is imprinting the objects. And our mind is capable of completely wiping them off. Samsara sindhostarane stupayaha. So the upaya is purely mind born, intelligence born. It is consciousness born. I will disclose it to you. Enaiva yata yatayosya param. By which method, resorting to which methodology? Yatayosya param. The striving souls have been able to reach the other shore. Tameva margam tava nirdishami. It is not a new method that I have discovered or found out. It has already been there, and many people have tried it. Many people have tried and they have succeeded. The same time-tested path I shall disclose to you. Be happy, be assured, be comfortable, be clear and convinced in your mind. Ma bhaishta vidvam stavanastyapayaha samsara sindhostarane stupayaha yenaiva yata yatayosya param tameva margam tava nirdishami astyupayo mahan kaschid samsara bhayanashanaha tena tirtva bhavam bodhim paramanandam aapsyasi astyupayo mahan kaschid
astupayo mahan kaschit
astupayo mahan kaschit
astupayo mahan kaschit
samsara bhayanashanah
samsara bhayanashanah
samsara bhayanashanah
samsara bhayanashanah
tena tirtva bhavam bodhim
tena tirtva bhavam bodhim
tena tirtva bhavam bodhim
tena tirtva bhavam bodhim
paramanandam apsyasi
paramanandam apsyasi
paramanandam apsyasi
paramanandam apsyasi
asti
asti
upayah
upayah
astyupayah
astyupayah
mahan
mahan
kaschid
kaschit
samsara bhayanashanah
samsara bhayanashanah
mahan kaschid samsara bhayanashanah
mahan kaschid samsara bhayanashanah
tena
tena
tirtva
tirtva
bhavam bodhim
bhavam bodhim
paramanandam
paramanandam
aapsyasi
aapsyasi
paramanandam aapsyasi astyupayah
astyupayah
upaya means a very clever dexterous means. Many people are not aware of it. There is a means. That upaya is certainly there. Don't doubt about it. I know it. I will tell you. Astyupayaha mahan kaschid. There is only one way. There are no two ways. The world has seen so many religions. If these religions are to take you to God, there is only one way. God is everywhere, all pervading. If God is all pervading, where do you have to go to see him or merge with him? He is everywhere, inside as well as outside you. Where are you running? So there is only a one straight line between two given points. So between you, the seeker, and God, the goal, there is a straight line, and the light is only one. So there cannot be many religions in this world. If it is a religion, the religion can only be one, to connect you with God. Only one way. Astyupayo mahan kaschid. It is some magnificent, great, great upaya. You know why it is great upaya? I don't know whether I should tell you. You know, there are so many people, crores and crores of devotees in our land. In devotional emotion, they are not lacking. But poor people have only emotion. Now, they have to encash their emotion and they must be able to discover and realize God. Now, in the matter of discovery and realization, you have to employ your intelligence. Now, as I am telling you, God is everywhere. Inside as well as outside. Where are you going in search of Him? If you cannot find Him in your heart, you will never find Him anywhere else. All experiences are inner. All experiences are mental. God experience also will be mental. Keeping the mind within you, should you search in your own mind and heart, or should you search outside in the manner of a pilgrimage? Tell me, is God distant or is He the closest? He is the closest. Unless you close your eyes and look for His presence within you,